Hover over a record category in the file plan and click View Details. The Category Details page displays, showing the disposition schedule summary. In the Disposition Steps section, click Edit. The Edit Disposition Schedule page displays. Click Add Step to select a disposition action. There are 5 disposition actions, but only 2 of these are available as the first step in a disposition schedule. Cut-off is usually the first step in the disposition schedule. Once a record is cut off, this triggers the record's retention period. Next, select whether the action will be triggered after a period of time or when a specified event occurs. If you select after a period of time, select the time period after which the step action will take place. Then enter a description for the step. And when you're done, click Save. Now click Add Step to add the next step in the schedule. You can see that more options are now available. If you select Destroy, then at the end of their life, records are removed from the records management system and destroyed. Again, you need to select whether the action will be triggered after a period of time or when a specified event occurs. Click Add Event to select an event. If you select both, you can choose for the step to occur either after whichever event is earlier or after both events have been completed. Now enter a step description and then click Save. When you've entered all the required steps, click Done. You return to the Category Details page, which displays the disposition steps. You can click View Disposition to the right of a step to display the description.